Sydney's glory comes in a vast variety of shapes and sizes, the architecture that makes up our city. Each year, special buildings are earmarked for what's called the Sydney Open, when we, the people, can step inside and enjoy the secrets.
Since 1913, the Registrar General's building has stood stark in sandstone, its crenellated turrets waiting for battle that will never come. Pug-faced gargoyles ready to spit rainwater from pursed lead lips. A place of power, not privy to punters sticky beaking, except for one weekend a year when it and 77 other city buildings open for Sydney Open.
The whole program is like a sushi train, and you see a dish go by and you might have a little taste. You see a building, it might have appeal, you go and see it.
Sydney Open covers the sacred, commercial, creative and industrial, from colonial landmarks in convict-built stone to modern skyscraping.
We like bold, unique design, and we also look for spaces that we think are going to be future heritage sites.
And in recent decades, landmarks like Australia Square have signalled our lofty lurch skywards.
It's a great statement about how we wanted to see the city in the future. So if we're going to build tall buildings, which we're going to have to, build them well.
From the morbid anatomy of the Lucy Osborne Nightingale building and the industrial powerhouse that was the Ryde water pumping station, to the top of Central Station's clock tower, to below the city in the tank stream, Sydney Open charts the different ways Sydney's skyline has evolved. Sydney Open opens for the first weekend of November. Mike Dalton, Nine News.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at ninenews.com.au.